Hey there, team. My name is John, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we are concluding our series, DTR, Defining the Relationships That Define Us. In week one of this series, we talked about covenants, how an integral part of any godly relationship is keeping your promises and commitments. Then last week, we talked about love, and how the love that God calls us to reflect in the world is not just a feeling, but it's also a love that is put to action. If you haven't watched either of those messages, please go back and do that. Now, a quick story for you. I still remember the day in second grade during reading time when my friend Trevor came up and hit me. And he didn't just hit me, but he punched me right in the holy cojones. And obviously it hurt, like real bad. But it didn't hurt so bad that I couldn't get him back. And I did, right in the jub-jubs. And the thing about that is, I didn't really have to think about that choice to hit him back. It was just naturally what I wanted to do in that moment. Just like he had punched me, I wanted to punch him back. And oftentimes in relationship, this is our natural inclination. When someone hurts us or causes us pain, we want to hurt them back. And because this is so natural, this desire to get even, this is normally what we choose. And when we choose to answer pain for pain, guess what? It causes more pain. And this is one thing that makes relationships so difficult, specifically relationships where hurt has been caused. Our natural inclination is to answer that hurt with hurt, which really only puts us in a cycle. And this cycle is not new. This is something that ancient people found themselves in as well. In fact, Jesus speaks directly to this cycle in his famous Sermon on the Mount, where he says, "You have heard it said, eye for eye, a tooth for a tooth." Just like us, the people in Jesus's day had this desire for recompense or for getting even. And so all throughout his ministry, we see Jesus time and time again teaching an alternative way of forgiveness. In that same Sermon on the Mount, Jesus taught his followers to daily pray for forgiveness. He tells parables and stories that challenge his disciples to lead radically forgiving lives. And forgiveness is not just something that Jesus talked about, it's something that he actually practiced. When he was on the cross, Jesus asked God to forgive the very people who were torturing and killing him. If you actually look at Jesus's life and teaching, it becomes very clear that a core aspect of being a follower of his is to engage consistently in this unnatural practice of forgiveness. And that word forgiveness in Greek simply means to release or to let go. When somebody wrongs us or hurts us in some way, it feels as if they owe us something. And the Bible often uses the language of a debt. And again, our natural desire is to get even or to get that debt paid back. But forgiveness is the act of releasing that other person from their need to pay that debt. You let them go as an act of grace, an act of mercy, and ultimately an act of love. And of course, this doesn't always feel good. This doesn't always feel right. Sometimes it feels like we're letting the other person get away with something. And let's be clear, forgiveness is a radical thing, but it is a radical thing that God has done for us, and therefore it's a radical thing that God calls his people to make central in their lives. Because again, forgiveness is not about getting even. Forgiveness is about breaking the cycle of hurt in a relationship, and about reflecting the heart of God as we do it. Very simply, forgiveness is how we keep hurt from becoming hate in a relationship. And it's how we eventually move toward healing. Getting back or getting even, while it may be tempting, it simply has no chance of bringing any healing, not to the relationship and not to the individuals within it. But forgiveness challenges us to release others from the debt that they owe us. And in doing so, we are often released from the hurt that they caused us. Maybe not completely at first, but forgiveness is at least a start. Instead of us getting back, the act of forgiveness gives us a chance to move forward. Just as Jesus' ultimate act of forgiveness on the cross made a way for us to move forward in our relationship with God, our willingness to forgive others makes a way for us to move forward in our relationship with them. And sometimes that means the relationship mends and grows and gets better, but other times a relationship moving forward means it has to come to an end. I want to be very clear. Forgiveness does not always mean reconciliation, but it always means healing. And so maybe you right now can think of a relationship in your life that is caught in this cycle of hurt. And maybe today, through this video, God is challenging you to be the one to take a step of forgiveness, to release that other person from the debt that they owe you, and therefore to release yourself from the hurt that they've caused you. As always, we have a download for you available in the description that will help guide you in making and marking that decision of forgiveness today, hopefully in a really practical way. So make sure before you leave, you stop by the description down by that and download this week's practice. Also, do not forget to check out the JohnCast this week. You can hear this message plus a conversation that I had with one of my dearest friends, Kaylee Moxley. We talked about dating. We talked about dating in the modern world. What does it look like as a Christian to engage in the dating scene right now, especially in the last 10 years when so much of dating has moved virtually, it's moved online. We talk about that a lot. It's a great conversation. I really recommend that you click the link in the description down below. Check out the JohnCast. Don't forget to download and subscribe and leave a review. That's all I have for you this week. I'll see you all next week as we kick off a brand new series. I love you all. Keep being awesome.